I want the attribute whose information gain is maximum. Out of 4, which attribute is having more information gain? Outlook is having more information gain. Immediately, I will make that outlook as a root node. What I will do? I will make that outlook as a root node. Observe the next slide. What is the node we have taken?
Outlook.
Why we have taken outlook as a root node? Because it has more information. What is the meaning here is Outlook is classifying the data set better way. That's why the reason we have taken Outlook as a root node. Now observe what we will do here. How many different values Outlook is taking here?
Three
different values. What are that?
Sunny,
overcast,
rain.
That's why this root node will have 3 branches. If only 2 values Outlook will take, it may consist of 2 branches. But here it is having 3 values. That's why 3 branches will be there. Leftmost subtree. This is rightmost subtree. Now observe carefully, whatever process we did, we have to repeat it for first subtree. We have to repeat it for second subtree. Then we have to repeat it for third subtree. But observe carefully. Some logic is here. Now observe. When Outlook is taking the value as Sunny, observe carefully in which example Sunny appears. Sunny appears in D1, it appears in D2, D8, D9, and D8. That's why in this branch I am only taking the examples. That's why I have written D1, D2, D8, D9, and D1. Have you understood why I am only taking the values? Because in these examples, Outlook is taking the value as Sunny. Out of all these values, 2 positive examples are there and 3 negative examples are there. It won't be the good news for us. Some examples are positive, some examples are negative. What is the problem we are solving? We are assigning a class. So either I should assign a positive class or negative class. I can do it when all the examples are positive or all the examples are negative. I can do that. If all the examples are positive, I will simply assign a positive class. Otherwise, I will assign a negative class. But problem was not solved here. Some examples are positive and some examples are negative. So that's why job is not yet over here. I should explore this part of the tree further. But also the second subtree is giving a good news for us. All examples are, job is done here. Now I am in a position to initialize a label. That's why the label S was initialized and we will stop exploring this tree. No need to explore the tree further because we got the label as S here. But same problem exists with the rightmost subtree also. Some examples are positive examples and some are negative. So job is not yet over. I have to explore this part of the tree further. Now what we will do here, I will take this portion of the tree and I will explore it further. So observe carefully what I will do. The most important thing to be remembered here, while going to the second section of constructing the tree, observe what are the examples I have taken. It is not the complete data set, right? I have only taken some examples. D1, D2, D8, D9 and D11. Why I have taken only that examples? Because when Outlook is taking the value as Sunny, it appears in only these examples. That's why the remaining portion of the tree will be constructed on this sub-examples. So this is the subset I will get here. I will repeat the same process once more. Again,